Hey, look at that, I survived. Early on a Sunday morning, at my lather landing zone, and I'm hoping the soap is residually slick. Get my shirt from over there on Take Care Man, Todd's site. So you want to go check out his merch, whatever, there you go. Anyway, if you saw yesterday's shave, you saw it was debacle. Now, I'm going to blame... Some of it could have been just me half awake. I'm going to blame the majority of it on the blade, but we're going to see. So I'm going to revisit. We're going back to the Berkeley Custom Shaver. We're on setting, I put it on, it's on 4. And I have a Wizamet blade put in it this time, rather than the Shark Platinum. Soap that we are using is, it's not that one. Sample that was given to me, Denton Mahique Hot Laguna Nights sample was given to me, and I'm not big on doing samples, but this one whipped up a beautiful lather, so looking forward to using that. I do have on my phone the scent notes. It has a ton of stuff going on in it. So I'm not going to read off everything that's in it, but it describes it as a beautiful citrus top notes with a little bit of sweetness mixed in. Sure to be a top warmer weather scent. Bring on those summer nights. So the top notes are lime, lemon, bergamot, orange, mandarin orange, neroli, jasmine, lavender. So there's a lot of citrus in there. But then it's got some middle C notes, nutmeg, rose, Brazilian rosewood. I'm just hitting a few of them. Bottom is white musk, cedar, oak moss, patchouli, amber, sandalwood, vetiver. There's a ton of stuff going on in this soap. Anyway, onto the shave. I'll wet my face and get lather. As I mentioned, if you saw the debacle yesterday, I had a nick here, a couple nicks, mainly just one here, and a good slice it took out of my skin there. Flapped it, I just pulled the skin off. Never done that with a razor before, other than a straight razor. And that thing just dug in and grabbed, and I'm in an open area, I never have. So, again, I was half awake, but I'm blaming it mostly on the blade, but we will see. So, obviously that might reopen, but I'm a daily shaver, and it will heal. And I don't edit my videos, so you got to see that debacle. It's a rare thing, but it happens. All right, let's go ahead. Still half awake, by the way, but we're going to be a little more cautious, especially over here. And not take it for granted. Someone on the forum had mentioned that it feels rough. Someone on the forum had mentioned, you know, with these vintage razors, things could be dropped or off or whatever, and that's a possibility. Although I have shaved with this before, and I don't think I had any issues. I have a video on it. I haven't gone back to watch the video. Clearly, I survived that time, too. Whiskers. Nothing else yet. Still looking good over there on that gouge. Pretty sure this is where I grabbed it too. When I crossed the grain pass, it dug in, so I'm going to be focused on this. Yeah, I mentioned yesterday too, the other Berkley razor. It has a little arrow under it on the handle here, and then there's X's and O's on the bottom plate. It's called the Shave Selector. This is the custom shaver, it's called, so. When I grabbed it before. Still no blood there yet, but here's the against the grain pass. Lovely lather with this, especially for me doing a bowl lather. Okay, here we go against the grain. So this razor was patented or produced in 1937, or around that time. And I'm assuming it preceded the other model I showed you, the Shave Selector, which does have a more comfortable feel shaving with it. This one does feel a little rough at times. Must be the angle it's holding it at. I don't know. But But it's not horrendous. Now that this wisdom that is breaking in too, feeling quite smooth. And it's sharp enough that it's actually cutting and not grabbing, peeling skin. I did feel it grab that scab from yesterday. Okay. Alrighty. So much better shave with it. Let me get a rinse. Scab. Just so we don't have a bloodbath of a shave video again. Anyway, so there you have it. The Berkley Custom Shaver comes in that box. I think some of it could be too. Just flexing that, not a lot, but there's not a lot of support for that blade. Anyway, that's my thoughts on it. The soap is a real winner. Beautiful. And I may get some when I run out of soap at some point. We will see. All right. Aftershave. Haven't even given thought to it. Let's start with some Humphreys first. You can see that spot did not open up again. I'm hoping that shows up on camera there. And we will go with Chisel Face Ghost Town Barber. So I appreciate Paul, Mr. Doug on the forum, sending these samples over on the forum and the thread that had been started for these. I posted their large samples, so there's a good bit left. And I'm more than happy to send this on to someone else. First person that private messages me over on DFS can get that. And the other one is Master of the Green, which I'm told is like a green Irish tweed. Dupe. So this one to me is very light. Very little taken out of that sample so far. So I'm getting overridden by the Ghost Town Barber. I'm not picking up the scents, but even when I smelled it yesterday, it was very light. These also came with splashes that I'm not using, and so I'll pass those on as well, still sealed. Again, Hot Laguna Nights is a nice citrus top notes. It's a nice fresh citrus scent. Anyway, there you have it. That's the shave today. Brush I was using was one from Jason, Jay Spartan, on the forums. Haven't seen him in a while. Hope he's doing well, with a cashmere knot in it. Anyway, Dave in Kentucky, be kind, be safe out there, and we'll see you on the pages.